back with you live on American Idol with the top 11 tonight. Results coming at you in just a moment. But first, let's see what the contestants were up to over the weekend for the Ford music video shoot, shall we? Roll that! AmericanIdol.com to watch all the four music videos. Plus, find out how you can get a VIP trip to the set of one of them and tickets to the show. While you're there, check out how you could take home an American Idol-inspired Ford Fiesta. I always wonder if you guys ever wreck during those shoots. No fender benders this time? Okay, good. And we found Andrew. Good, we got you. It's a crucial week for these contestants on the couch. Surviving this cut is really important. Then they secure a spot on the summer tour, and there's only room for 10 contestants. How we doing, gang? Okay?
Yeah.
Very quiet. Let's chat with you guys for a second just to see what's on your mind. Casey, let me ask you. Yesterday, you had an eye-opening experience before we went on the air. We didn't talk about it last night during the show, but prior to what happened?
Thank you for that.
You're welcome.
Rehearsal was a little crazy. I completely went into the second verse when I was supposed to go to the chorus of my song, and it just freaked me out big time, so I was a little bit on edge last night.
And how about after your performance, how'd you feel?
I felt a lot better because I didn't wreck it. So, you know, thank you to the band, by the way.
Well, good luck tonight, Casey. Siobhan's boss is here in the audience. And is his name Brooks?
Yeah.
Okay, Brooks will not shave until she wins. And I felt like we should just take a look at how the beard is going there. And then her friends are next to, what are your friends, what do they call themselves?
Shivambis.
The Shivambis, that's right. Next to Rob Zombie, it looks like, with the beard. And I was talking to Katie's dad before the show, and he was sprinting away from the studio. And so I said to him, where are you going? The results are about to come on. Why does he leave during this show?
My dad can't like watch me and my brother in competition because if we lose, he hates seeing like the sadness on our faces. So right now, my dad is across the street, probably having a drink or something. And he's getting the play-by-play from friends back home who are watching it live. So right now, somebody's probably texting him saying they're talking about you.
That actually sounds more like self-torture than being here.
I don't know. He goes, Katie, I mean, I don't know if you're going home, but I can't go because I feel like if I go, then you'll be kicked off. So he's just going to stay over there until he finds out.
Tipping the cups and creating a hangover for himself. Hey, so Big Mike, I saw this footage upstairs earlier, and I had to show it because, you know, Big Mike has other responsibilities outside of American Idol. Take a look at Mike babysitting and his special package here. I'm not so sure people are aware of how it works in terms of you and where you have to stay and where your family has to stay. So you don't actually sleep in the same place at night, right?
Oh, no. They have a little apartment a little ways away, and I see them every night, you know, so almost nights. And, you know, it's crazy not live. We've lived together since we left high school. We moved in together, so it's crazy right now.
And what do you think when you look down at that little baby in your Bjorn there?
She's just so peaceful, you know, and it's just like so blessed to have her. You know, my wife told me the other day, she found our dog. She finally like saw her and just watched her back and forth all day. So it was beautiful.
Well, very good. Good luck to you, Mike.
Thank you.
Cut to the chase, guys. Last week, we pulled out the bottom three. We're going to do the same this week. We've got the stools on the other side of the stage, and soon they will be filled. Dim the lights, and here we go with your results. Let's go back to Siobhan to start. Siobhan, please stand up, darling. You sang Superstition. The judges loved your conviction and how you expressed yourself. But Simon thinks you have to push yourself even more and not rely on your screen. What do you think about his comment about relying on your screen?
You know, honestly, I knew he'd say that. And in a way, I totally agree. This week was so important to all of us. And if I had to do it one more time to get through to the top 10, it's something that I can do, and it's different. So I just, you know, I'm willing to challenge myself and change things up in the future, but it's just, I just wanted to have as much fun as I could so that it would show. I understand.
After the nationwide vote, Siobhan, you're going to have to pack your bags this summer because you're going out on tour. Congratulations. You are safe. Okay. Next, let's go to Lee and Casey. You guys both stand up here for a second. Lee, you sang The Letter. While Kara and Randy thought you raised the bar, Simon questioned your song choice, but Ellen was happy to have her favorite pen back. Casey, you sang Power of Love. The judges didn't love your song choice either, but three of them really liked your vocal. Then there was Mr. Cal, who thought he was listening to an 80s cover band, he said. I mean, to Randy, to Ellen, to Kara, after watching it back, do you guys still feel that you were right and Almighty was wrong?
100% right. 100%.
Definitely.
Definitely.
Ellen?
I thought he had great vocals. I loved it at home. I was very happy with the vocals.
You still stick to your path, Simon?
Yes.
He seems so sweet, doesn't he?
Yeah.
After the nationwide vote, both of you stay there for 1 second. Let's go to Tim and Paige. Both stand up. Tim, you sang Crazy Little Thing Called Love. All the judges thought you missed the mark on that one. They also criticized your stage antics and thought you made the performance corny. Although it was a nice slide, though, Tim. If you had to do it all over again, listening to their critique, and you could have a do-over, would you do it differently?
You know, I've obviously thought about that quite a bit since last night, and I had so much fun last night that I don't think I'd really do it over again. It was different. It was a change for me. I had a blast. I think it was entertaining, and, you know, that's what I was going for.
Paige, you sang Against All Odds. The judges all agreed that the performance was off. Kara and Simon thought you had stopped competing in the show. Now that you've had a chance to let it sink in over 24 hours, what do you think happened last night? What went wrong, in your opinion?
I lost myself in the song. I didn't stop competing, but I definitely lost myself in the song. So it was a poor performance.
Randy, looking at those two faces, Tim and Paige, who is in the bottom three, Randy, based on not knowing? I know you don't have the result, but in your opinion, who is in the bottom three?
God, right. It was both of you guys last night. Really, it was not good. But Paige, it's probably the worst I've ever heard you, and I don't know what was happening. So I would probably say Paige.
Randy is right. Unfortunately, Paige, darling, I'm sorry. You are in the bottom three tonight. And so is Tim, guys. Tim is in the bottom three as well. Two of your bottom three, Tim and Paige. So who will join them? We'll find out in just a little bit. Plus, when we come back, Miley Cyrus, our mentor, takes the stage.